Lucy Noelin Kansime, the Cancer Screening and Prevention Project Coordinator URDT in Kakumiro and Kagadi, says since its inception in 2017, a total of 1,300 sexually active women aged between 25 and 49 have had free screening and prevention from over 10 sub-counties and health centers.
Of course, the positivity rate is not all that high. It's now 4%, and we feel we have sensitized people enough, and they feel they can access these services.
She adds that over 40 village health teams have been trained in cancer screening. The project targets to screen over 7,500 women in 2 years.
1,033 women since the project started. Of course, we started with capacity building for almost one quarter, and now we are in the second quarter. And also we have trained 20 midwives who are also training others, and so far they have trained 26 midwives. Other midwives, they are training them on job.
Justin Tumwebaze Aisha, the Kakadi District Health Educator, says some men have prostate cancer and need to be screened and treated as they accompany their wives for cervical cancer screening. She further asks parents to ensure that their daughters, aged between 10 to 13, are vaccinated against the human papillomavirus.
To be escorting these women to go to the health facilities so that they may do what? They may also be screened against the what? The cancer of the prostate. Because cancer of the prostate is also affecting men, most especially when they delay going to the facility and they are confirmed very late.
The Kakumiro District Community Health Officer, Dr. Robert Senteza, says there are other challenges and a lot of misconceptions about cervical cancer.
There is still a challenge. But of course, even a lion, I mean an elephant, is eaten starting with a piece. Let's first embrace the 5 and the 4, consolidate the gains from this.
The beneficiaries expressed happiness over the free service of cervical cancer screening and asked the government to equip health centers with health equipment. Report by Andrew Musingzi for the news.